I'm Hayley Legs for Total Rock here at Bloodstock Festival 2022 with Jazz from Killing Joke.
Yeah, hi everyone. How you doing? It's a beautiful day here.
Yeah, it's beautiful. A bit much, but Jazz likes it apparently.
Yeah,
he likes sweating his balls off.
Yeah.
I don't know if you remember me, but I breathed fire for you at Brixton Academy a few years ago.
Did you? Was that you?
I did, yeah.
Do you think we could get away with it today?
I think it's hot enough, actually, and I didn't bring my stuff. But next time,
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you were just saying you don't... I mean, I don't want to jinx you by asking the question.
No, you can't. We're going to do war dance.
You're going to do war dance? I was going to say, so if people, like, wish you well before the gig, you have to do...
That's good. As if they, as if they say one thing. I mean, we just don't like talking about a gig before...
Fair
we
enough.
Do it, yeah. Yeah.
It's quite wacky.
Yeah, it is quite wacky. It's youthful. He keeps giving me more and more superstitions. I've got enough with magpies and everything else.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah. And so, like, anyway, yeah, we're a bit too superstitious.
Yeah, we or you? Like, the whole band or just you?
The
being
whole band.
Superstitious. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So you're all a bit wacky.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you've been going for, I think it was it your 43rd anniversary of your first gig last week?
Is that right?
Wikipedia says so.
Oh, no, it must be. Our first gig was in 1979.
So.
And so we are now, what?
So yeah, that's 43 years?
43 years.
Fucking hell.
Yeah, I know.
That's a long time.
It's a long time, and the same guys as well. Can you imagine being in a band 43 fucking years?
I haven't been alive that long, so no.
But what happens is you kind of get to know the guys more than your own blood family.
Yeah.
Now, that's a kind of a strange bonding. I mean, we've been through absolutely everything together, and it's amazing. Sometimes the... My memories of some of the craziest things that happened. I'm glad these guys are still alive so I can say, did that really happen?
Yeah.
You know, like real crazy stuff. Wow.
Can I have an example of one?
Oh God, there's so many. Where would we begin?
You can tell me 10 if you like.
Oh God. Well, look, I had one 3 days ago, right? On a Tuesday, I go to this like marijuana club, okay, which is in Prague.
Oh, yeah.
And they're the strongest types of like weed and like hash on a Tuesday afternoon. And they put it in this kind of weird vaporizer thing. Anyway, so I had like about 5 hits on this super strong hash the other day. And I couldn't speak properly after. I was like, so I thought, something's going wrong. So I rang up my fucking doctor, and he goes, something sounds wrong with you. You sound like you're having a strong... I was like this, you know. So he called the fucking ambulance, and they took me to the fucking hospital, and they said, you must have smoked something really strong. You all right? We checked you out. The brain scans, everything scanned. Well, that was last week.
I remember actually on the gig we did. Oh my God! On the gig we did together, I remember one of your crew guys smuggled in a load of weed in a VCR player. I'm like, surely that looks... The fact that it was like 2015 or something and you had a VCR,
listen,
surely looked suspicious.
The band is even worse now than we used to be. I mean, in 1981, check this out, okay? In Iceland, hashish was £25 for 1 gram, okay? So Geordie and myself, we set up this bogus record company. And like we were shipping in like cassettes. They were packed full of hash. We had one guy in Iceland there. And I had a grand piano and a big apartment, and we had the whole of Iceland sewn up for 1 year. And then shit started happening. We thought, let's get out of here.
This was the energy I needed today. Thank you. So, would it be fair to say you're a bit reclusive? Because you do go and move to these like odd middle of nowhere places.
I do, yeah, right? I do, yeah. I like to move country when there's not a pandemic. I like to move, even the pandemic, I lived in Lima, and then I went to Mexico and got into trouble there.
Yeah, you had a near-death... Well, we'll talk about that in a minute. We'll get back
around to
that.
Yeah, no, I like moving all the time. I'm kind of like a gypsy, really. If you saw my one of my apartments, I normally have a bag that is permanently unpacked.
Yeah.
Because I'm always going off somewhere, so it's not even worth fucking taking everything out. Like, most weeks I'm on a plane somewhere or going somewhere, and I've got mates all the way around the world. Remember, my home is down there, so I go like this way round to get home, then I go the other way round to get back.
Yeah.
You know, and I go see everybody on both ways round. The maximum flying I've done in 1 year, I've been 18 times round the world in 1 year.
Crikey.
I don't know many people who do that except pilots, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
So like these kind of things have been fun. I don't like living a normal life.
Evidently.
I've never had a job, ever. Ever.
You don't consider this to be a job?
Of course not. I mean, it's hard on the body. I mean, the life, and I mean, kill you quick if you're not careful.
But, yeah.
When I was 14, I smoked my first joint. I thought, this fucking sucks. Hey, I'm not doing any more school work. I'm in a formal band immediately, and that's the end of everything. That's it, and that's what happened, you know.
It's a good thing you were successful, huh?
Well, I think with willpower, you look in my eyes, hey, with willpower, you don't want to look too hard. With willpower, everything is possible. Everything is possible.
You tell them.
No, I mean, the thing is, most of my dreams have come true. And now I've got to think of a new set of dreams to do to keep myself busy.
What's that going to be?
Well, the first problem we got is like this winter. Somehow I've got to transform the Killing Jokes Gatherers, what you call a fan club, into like looking after each other so that no one goes hungry this Christmas. Like, you know, because we're going to have like food shortages.
Yeah.
We can see this is going to happen, and people are going to go really cold. I mean, look, and it's affecting our business. Look, all the recording studios, all the rehearsal studios, their bills now are three times too much. So, like, can you imagine, like, after this Christmas, so much of our industry is going to go down because of power bills and everything. So I'm very concerned about this, and I'm looking at more innovative ways how we can get our gatherers, which you call fans, I think is an insulting word, but to actually monitor each other, make sure everyone's fed.
Yeah.
There's small things like this, you know, that really mean these fucking politicians, I've got no time for them. We should be increasing food supply now. Food and water is a human right. You know?
Yeah, absolutely.
And so, this is a time of service for me. I don't want to see people suffering and going to hungry, and this winter is going to be like no other winters.
Yeah, we're
going to be lucky either. If we get the other side of it, because we got the Royal Albert Hall in May.
You do, yeah.
No, when is it? March, right? So anyway, let's hope we don't have World War III full on, like we all get nukes before March, right?
Yeah, that would suck.
But there's
it?
Always a chance these things can happen, because we've got multiple flashpoints in the world. You know, like it's much worse than Russia and like the old Soviet Union in the days. You've got like the axis from Israel to Iran, you've got Taiwan, you've got like North Korea, and then you've got Ukraine, and like the list just goes on. Like, something's gonna fucking happen, isn't it?
Right.
You know, like something's gonna happen. You can feel something's gonna happen. And that, our next conversation will be after it happens.
Oh,
that's a scary thought, yeah. Isn't it? We've got to get through to next year. My take on it is, I wouldn't be surprised, and God forbid, if they let off a nuke before the next Killing Joke gig.
Yeah, and then God you forbid. Miss Royal Albert Hall.
Yeah, no, well, I think that they would contain action like that in a way that just terrifies people, and people will just accept anything the government say. The reason why all these governments want to go to war is so that there's no democracy, so they can do anything they want. When you're on a war footing, you know, basically there's no freedom.
Yeah.
So like, I'm very concerned about everything, and this rock music is one song. It's called Freedom, and that's what we're doing. That's why it's so important. I love what we all do.
especially you. So, near-death experience. What
yeah,
happened?
Well, that's right. Well, that's right. That's absolutely right. I went into a coma, you see. And everything was very peaceful. And I knew I was going to die, and I didn't. And that's why, to sum it all up, I believe I have a very special mission with my remaining years, you know? I do. I really sincerely believe that. And but we'll see, you know? I believe, I'm going to do something very important. And that's why I was brought back from death. So I'm just going to try and do what I can before my time's up, you know?
Well, I look forward to seeing all of that.
Yeah, we'll see. I'm going to surprise you all.
Yes, please.
Yeah.
And looking forward to where I love it all. That's going to be a banger, I'm
Life
sure.
is good.
Life is good. Thank you so much for talking to us.
Yeah.